The latest strikes on Zaporizhzhia came after an explosion on Saturday, caused the partial collapse of a bridge linking the Crimean Peninsula with Russia. Russian President Vladimir Putin has accused Ukraine of orchestrating the attack, describing it as an act of terrorism. The Kremlin says Putin will be meeting with the Security Council Monday. Ukraine has not claimed responsibility. Bail services and partial road traffic have resumed, and drivers are set to inspect the bridge. The Kerch Bridge attack damaged an important supply route for the Kremlin's war effort and a symbol of Russia's power in the region. Russia seized Crimea from Ukraine in 2014, and the 19-kilometer bridge linking the region to its transport network was opened 4 years later. Overnight, Russian missile strike killed 17 people and injured dozens of others in the latest deadly attack to hit the southern Ukrainian city of Zaporizhzhia. The barrage damaged at least 20 private homes and 50 apartment buildings. Zaporizhzhia lies close to the front line, where Kyiv's forces have been carrying out large-scale counterattacks against Russian troops. In recent weeks, Russia has repeatedly struck the city, which is the capital of the region of the same name, annexed by Moscow's last week in violation of international law. A near-death experience. That's how former Senator Laila de Lima described Sunday's ordeal when she was taken hostage by a fellow detainee inside her detention cell at the Philippine National Police Custodial Center, which is right in the heart of the PNP's headquarters in Kamkrame, Quezon City. Three detained members of the terrorist group Abu Sayyaf tried to escape the facility on October 9. Two were shot and killed as they tried to flee, while one of them held de Lima hostage when authorities caught up with him. PNP Chief Rodolfo Azurin Jr. told ABS-CBN's Teleradio, de Lima isn't hurt and safe after her hostage taker was neutralized by responding operatives. The head of the custodial service unit where de Lima is detained has been relieved from his post.
Sige muna natin na OIC, yung deputy, para na sa ganun ay siya na muna ang magpalakad ng custodial center. Si Senator de Lima, kagabi po ay dilipat po natin siya pansamantala sa PNP General Hospital para makapagpahinga po siya habang inaayos po ang kanyang facility kasi doon nga po nangyari yung insidente. So medyo nililinis pa po na inaayos. And naghahanap po tayo ng ibang facility doon sa loob ng custodial center na pwede po niyang paglipatan para yun pong kahit pa paano, hindi po niya naalala yung naging insidente.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. tweeted about the incident on Sunday, saying that he would ask de Lima if she would like to be transferred to another facility. But Interior Secretary Benhura Abalos says she has declined. Former Senator de Lima still recovering from Sunday's traumatic experience. In a statement, she said a pointed object, possibly a screwdriver or ice pick, was pointed at her chest. She was also blindfolded by her capture. De Lima thanked the police for saving her life. Her camp is now considering applying for home furlough amid fears of De Lima's safety. Her lawyer, attorney Filibon Tacardon, says this is the first time they are exploring this option, dispelling some senators' claims that the PNP and the Justice Department had formally offered to have De Lima on house arrest earlier this year.
We have to consider the situation and the background of that offer. You know, we all know that when Senator Markey tried to first visit Senator Laila de Lima, his team was prevented by PNP. And when Senator Laila tried to raise it with the custodial center officers, that was the time that the offer was made. And actually, the offer was made this way, according to Senator Laila. Kung hindi na po kayo masaya sa amin, pwede naman kayong lumipat. It was not really a formal offer to transfer and there was no options provided for her at that time.
De Lima spokesperson, Attorney Dino De Leon, also not discounting the possibility that the prisoners' escape plot was just a ruse and that they were really out for De Lima.
Right now, we can only theorize. We have to be able to get the data and the facts straight. And anything's possible at this point in time. I personally, I'm not speaking in behalf of the entire team, but I personally do not discount that possibility that it was the senator that I believe was specifically targeted. And why is it that they know where to go? takot na takot nga sila ng mga ordinary visitors like foreigners going to the to Centro Dayo de Lima. Grabe yung security features. Yung pala makakapasok is somebody from the inside na supposedly guarded rin yung inmate na ito.